Hello friends, welcome to BSc Agriculture. If you are coming to my channel for the first time, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button. So let's move to the video. In this video, we are going to see about entomologist crop wise pest classification. I am going to cover the topic of pest of safflower. So while seeing about the safflower, these are the pests which was present in safflower crop. So I have given the common name as well as scientific name and their family and order in the column. So if you want to see some other pest, we can able to see the some of the pest playlist in the final end of video, so you can able to catch it out. So let's move to the video for safflower insects. So the first one, safflower caterpillar, where the scientific name is Condica capensis, and which where the major symptom is it used to feeds on the leaves as well as flowers. For its identification, the larva is said to be dark brown with a humped posterior part. And as well as while seeing the adult, and the adult is said to be a dark brown forewing as in the light brown hind wings present in them. So the management for this caterpillar is intercropping the non-host crops like wheat in the safflower field, and also use the application of excessive application of nitrogen should be avoided in the field, and also spray of carbaryl TWP at 2.5 to 3 kg per hectare or fenvalerate at 20 EC at 250 ml per hectare is an effective control for this caterpillar. And then second one is safflower aphid, and the scientific name is Euroleucon carthami. And while saying about the symptom of damage, they use it to cause the curling and yellowing of tender leaves due to the sucking of saps from the host plant, and the sucking pots which use it to also secrete honeydew on its upper surface of the leaves, so which use it to infest as well as cause the secondary infections like black sooty mold, which use it to grow on the hindering pots of the honeydew secretion, and which use it to result in the stunted growth of the plant. And finally the pot used to dry up is the dry up, and the whole plant used to die is the major problem in safflower aphid. And so identification, while seeing about the nymph is said to be a reddish brown, and adult is said to be a large size black with pear shaped body as well as conspicuous conicles are present in the adult ones. So it is a picture of aphids. And management practices we can able to go for aphids are avoiding of late sowing, and if attack is observed border rows, we must able to take control measures by removing the affected plant, and also avoid excess use of nitrogen, and also maintain two or three rows of maize or sorghum around the field, which reduces the entry of aphids into the field. And we can also able to release chrysoperla eggs or grubs at 1 to 2 plant, and we can able to conserve natural predators which was present in the field. Or else if the pest incidence is even high, we can able to move for chemical spraying like spray dimethoate 30 EC at 750 ml per hectare or at the rate of 40 and 60th day after sowing. Or else we can able to move for the spraying of monocrotophos at 0.05% in the field level, and these chemicals can be sprayed at the volume of 500 liters of spray mixture, or else 20 kg dust formulation per hectare can be applied is an effective one against aphids. And the next one is butterfly, and the scientific name is Acanthophilus helianthi, or else which is used to come under the family Tepetidae and the order Diptera. So these are said to be a maggots. So the butterfly use infectious stage is maggots. So maggots which are wringler like small caterpillars, so which use it to feeds on the birds, and it also use it to affected birds show bore holes, and which use it to produce a rotten with a foul smell in the field, and all it is given the bud which use it to show a soaked appearance in the field level. And the maggots are which is dirty white in color, and the adult for identification, the adult which is said to be small ashy color fly which used to present with the bristles. So it was the picture of safflower butterfly. And while seeing about the nature of damage, the newly hatched larva which used to feeds on the soft parts of the capsule is a characteristic damage, and the affected boreholes is used to show small boreholes present in the capsules, and the infested buds which used to give rotten smell, and also the ooze coming out of the buds is the characteristic symptom of the sawflower bud fly. And the management practice is we can able to move for the chemical sprayings like dimethoate 30 EC, or smalathiol 50 EC, or posporient 100 EC at the required dosage in the field level. And about 600 to 650 liter of water is needed for spraying in about 101 hectare area in the field level is the normal for safflower. And the next one is flower rubber, where the scientific name is Eublema rivula, and the larva which is said to be a green with a black head, and also used to present with the long white hairs on the body. And the major characteristic symptom is the larva which used to whips the flower heads and bores into the pots is the characteristic symptom of flower rubber. And the next one is Helicobacter armigera, which you use it to feed on leaves and pods of different parts. If you want to see about Helicobacter armigera, you can able to see the playlist of some other major crops. So I have detailedly classified about Helicobacter armigera, and I have given the lecture notes in description. So comment about the video and join us in the Instagram page. So if you like the video, like it and share it with your friends, and subscribe to BSC Agriculture and hit the bell icon to get regular updates. So thanks for watching the video. I'll catch up in the next videos.